देखो मैं बताता हूँ, ए बी सी डी यहाँ से मतलब लिस्ट अकॉर्डिंग टू लिस्ट यहाँ से स्टार्ट है, यहाँ खत्म है।
Very good.
Good evening, dignitaries, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Pallavi Ramaswamy. On behalf of Foreign Service Institute, Ministry of External Affairs, I'd like to welcome you all to the valedictory function of the Indian Foreign Service Officer Trainees of 2014 batch. We warmly welcome the esteemed and august presence of Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs, General Dr. Vijay Kumar Singh, who has kindly consented Officer Trainee 2014 batch to present a bouquet to him. I believe everything that begins has to conclude. But every conclusion marks a new beginning. And so says this valedictory function. This valedictory function marks the completion of the first tunnel through which a diplomat's life passes. This tunnel mentors the officer trainees to envision themselves as future diplomats and ambassadors. May I now request Sri Amarendra Khatua, the Dean of Madras.
Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs, President and members of the Association of Indian Diplomats, colleagues from the Ministry of External Affairs, Indian Foreign Service Officer Trainees of 2014 batch and their family members and friends, other invitees, ladies and gentlemen, thank you all, especially the Honorable Minister of State for honoring us with your august presence in the valedictory function for the Indian Foreign Service Officer Trainees of 2014 batch. Let me start my brief remarks by congratulating all the officer trainees for successfully completing the training schedule and now preparing to start their eventful journey as diplomatic representatives of the people and government of India. You represent India as unity in diversity in finest form, consisting of trainees from 16 different states and unions, union territories, consisting of 14 engineers and 3 doctors, consisting with 13 with previous job experience in government sector and 15 in the private sector. All of you, officer trainees, have gone through a series of modules developed and still evolving in the Foreign Service Institute and in various institutes, missions, divisions of our ministry over the last 2 years. The training process theoretically and to some extent practically prepared you to confront the rigors and vicissitudes of the diplomatic career spread over a period of next 34 to 36 years. You will represent India and its global aspirations of 1200 million people identifiable personal and professional goals, and above all, achievable ambitions of a changing and emerging world power. Our Honorable Prime Minister and External Affairs Minister have now defined our foreign policy paradigm. This shift will short, medium, and long-term achievables, both in bilateral and multilateral fronts. You will be the active frontman in the field of trade, commerce, science and technology, political and bilateral, cultural, consular work to promote India's interest, to build up India's image, and to maintain inter-ministerial pan-India reflections in your diplomatic work. The world of today is equally one of unprecedented opportunities and grave challenges. The pressure and momentum of events happening on the global arena will often leave you with too little time to think. You may not always get the opportunity of stepping back and reflecting, analyzing the situation, and pondering over various available alternatives before deciding on the action to be taken. Most of the time, you will have to respond in a very swift manner. Moreover, our organizational strength is leaner than most other ministries and almost all other foreign services of major countries. With less than 700 IFS officers, we are managing 162 missions and posts abroad, apart from managing the ministry in Delhi. The implication is that you would need to master various disciplines and keep yourself updated all the time about various developments. You must be alert, agile, and active at all times. Our missions need officers to manage a flurry of activities and to cope with the pace set by the government. This has led the ministry and FSI to review your training. For the current and future batches of IFS officer trainees, the training has been made more structured, shorter, and precisely focused in order to facilitate the posting of officers at missions at the earliest possible. I wish you all the very best for your first posting abroad and hope that you all will utilize all the information and knowledge that we have attempted to impart to you during the training. I wish you all the very best. Thank you.
Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs, General Dr. V.K. Singh, Dean of the Foreign Service Institute, Ambassador Amarendra Katwa, fellow members of the Association of Indian Diplomats, senior officials of the Ministry of External Affairs, graduating officer trainees of the IFS 2014 batch and their family members and friends, ladies and gentlemen. At the outset, permit me to join the others in congratulating the 2014 batch on their successful completion of their training and on embarking on their career full of zeal and expectations. You all would be impatient to practice all that you have learned and imbibed in the last 2 years. In this journey, you carry with you our good wishes from those who have tread similar roads in yesteryears. May your exciting journey be satisfying and at the same time, we hope, enjoyable. As this is your valedictory function, I thought it appropriate to give you a few pointers that might serve you in your professional career. Do remember that we in the Foreign Service may help in the formulation of foreign policy, but our main task is the efficient and timely implementation of policy as decided by our government. Very briefly, our foreign policy has 5 broad objectives. Number 1, we have to preserve the political sovereignty and territorial integrity of India at all times, maintaining the strategic autonomy in decision making of India is of paramount importance. The second issue, of course, is the economic independence and inclusive economic growth and development of the country, and everything that goes with it, whether it's trade and commerce, investment, attracting foreign direct investment, technology transfer, energy security, and the rest. The third important point is to make India's voice heard in all international, multilateral, regional, bilateral fora, be it the UN, the WTO, climate change, nuclear proliferation, counterterrorism, SEO, SAARC, ASEAN, you name it, you have it. The next important point is, of course, is the Indian diaspora. Extremely important for a country like India, because they are the bridge between the countries where they have settled and their motherland. We have to look after them, we have to interact with them, and we have to get the best out of them. And the fifth and the final, it is not least. India is a mother civilization, along with Persia, Rome, and Greece, and Egypt, and China perhaps. India has a civilization that is millennial old, and therefore its footprint is across the globe. We have to be mindful of that. Whether it is yoga, whether it is Bollywood, whether it is curry, whether it is philosophy, whether it is music, whether it is art, whether it is places of tourist destination, India has it all and is absolutely second to none. We have to be proud of our cultural and civilizational heritage at all times. Now a word about the Association of Indian Diplomats, which I represent at the moment. The association is a gathering of former ambassadors and high commissioners of India and those who have held senior posts in international organizations at the level of Under Secretary General and above. With nearly 290 members, the association has established itself as a reservoir of enormous experience and knowledge that can be called upon when needed. Operating as a think tank, it has participated in many task forces, contributing analysis and policy options for the government. Members of the association have also been the mainstay of the distinguished lecture series of the ministry covering outlying institutions and universities in India. Our main outreach public diplomacy activity, supported by the ministry, is our flagship publication, the Indian Foreign Affairs Journal, now in its 11th year. It has come to stay as an invaluable addition to the repertoire of authentic international relations publications on India. The oral history section has been specially welcomed in India and abroad and has established itself a niche for itself. Members of the association have been intimately connected with the training schedule of the officer trainees and contributing as advisors, visiting faculty, resource persons for the dissertations, mentors to individual trainees, and so on. We consider our association with the Foreign Service Institute as a privilege and are bound in duty to give back the service that had been, and in some cases, continue to be our life. Today, the association would be awarding two prizes to be presented by the Honorable Minister of State for the best dissertation, that would be a gold medal, and for the best officer training, which would be a book prize of 4,000 rupees. Both these awards have been made possible by corpus established with the family of the late Ambassador Bimal Sanyal, which is administered by the association. Of course, there will be many other medals and prizes that the Honorable Minister will be giving out too. Late Ambassador Bimal Sanyal was a visionary and a pioneer who saw economic diplomacy as an increasingly important aspect of future foreign relations. He established a separate economic wing in the Ministry of External Affairs that has today blossomed into a major part of the ministry's functioning. We are very thankful to the Foreign Service Institute for its assistance in the selection of the awardees and also for hosting this event. Once again, our best wishes to the graduating officer trainees. Jai Hind!
Those were the real words coming out of the Doyen's mouth. Now I'd like to call upon Dr. Gautam Kumar Pandey, IFS officer trainee of 2014 batch, to share his experience in the service.
Respected Honorable Minister of State, Sri V.K. Singh sir, Secretary and Dean FSI, Sri Amrin Khatwa sir, President Association of Indian Diplomats, Sri Amitabh Tripathi sir, other distinguished guests, and my dear colleagues. They say that from small beginnings come great things. And today we begin on a journey to represent the dreams and aspirations of more than 1.25 billion Indians abroad and to secure national interest for our country. The increasing integration of the world provides both challenges and opportunities for Indian Foreign Service. The horizons of Indian Foreign Service is continuously expanding to include commercial and economic agendas, security and strategic affairs, environmental issues, multilateralism, and liaising with our states back home. Incidentally, all this is in sync with vision and developmental agenda which our Honorable Prime Minister has set to achieve for this great nation of ours. Moreover, at Foreign Service Institute, we have been aptly trained for the job, with our training schedule reflecting and catering to the reality of the present times, where adequate weightage was given to training in economic diplomacy, international law, India's neighborhood policy, and a special emphasis on communication skills. Knowledge of our culture, language, history, and values are integral to promotion of brand India abroad, and FSI has rightly managed to train us on those lines. I feel privileged to bring to your kind notice that Batch 2014 got a chance to participate and work in events which brought international acclaim and goodwill to India, such as Third India-Africa Forum Summit, evacuation during Yemen crisis, and relief work during Nepal earthquake. I learned most from my batchmates. The knowledge and experiences they brought on the table by virtue of being from diverse background enriched us all. We debated, we discussed, and we argued. Sometimes we agreed, sometimes we didn't. But at all the times, we learned something from each other. We understand that we cannot direct the winds, but we can adjust the sails. In this ever-changing world, to deliver the best for our country, we need to learn, unlearn, and relearn the relevant skills and capabilities. And let me assure you, dear sirs and maps, Batch 2014 has got that indomitable spirit to do so. Our seniors, ex-ambassadors, and diplomats have left footprints and a legacy for all of us to follow. You all are our guiding force and our motivation to excel in the path we have chosen to serve our great nation. I take this opportunity to thank JSERS Sri G.V. Srinivas sir, under whose able guidance we got trained at FSI. On behalf of FSI, I would also like to thank Minister of State Sri V.K. Singh sir for instituting Silver Medal for Best Officer Trainee this year. Sir, these medals are symbolic, but they provide an incentive for OTs to push their limits to excel. Dear sirs and ma'ams, we do not want to arrive, we want to travel. And on this journey, we would always need your guidance, support, and blessings. Every story has an end, and every end is a new beginning. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Pandey. Ladies and gentlemen, it's time now for the distribution of awards to the Indian Foreign Service Officer Trainees of 2014 batch. I'd request the Honorable Minister of State to kindly come up the stage to give away the awards. Congratulations, Ms. Tiwari, again. The next is Ambassador Bimal Samyal Memorial Book Prize for the Best Officer Trainee. And that again goes to Ms. Nidhi Tiwari. Comprising esprit de corps and participation in extracurricular activities. And this goes to Dr. Gautam Kumar Pandey. Congratulations, sportspersons, both female and male. The best sportsperson female goes to Ms. Veena Prabhatirke. Goes to Dr. Vineet Kumar. Trainees of 2014 batch on stage to receive their certificates that pronounce the completion of their training. Ms. Renu Yadav. Ms. Deepak Padmakumar. Mr. Abhishek Upadhyay. Shri Ajit John Joshua. Shri Kapi Dhwaj Pratap N. Singh. Ms. Nidhi Tiwari. Ms. Udita Gaurav. Ms. Prerna Shahi. Shri Raghu Puri. Dr. Gautam Kumar Pandey. Shri Gaurav Gupta. Ms. Renu. Ms. Sunena. Ms. Anupama Singh. Ms. Neha Singh. Ms. Saloni Sahai. Dr. Vineet Kumar. Shri Ashwini Kumar. Shri Sulfule Madhav Racheya. Shri Sameer Dilip Akolkar. Ms. Barkha Tamrakar. Shri Karan Yadav. I think he's not there. Shri Vipul Dev. Shri Manas Raj Patel. Shri Vishal Jayesh Bhai Harsh. Ms. Garima Paul. Shri Vishal Jyoti Das. Shri S. Fahad Ahmad Khan. Ms. Veena Prabha Tirke. And last but not the least, Shri Dharmendra Kumar. We thank the Honorable Minister of State for giving. I now invite the Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs to please address the audience.
I think the administration can heave a sigh of relief because you people will be added on to the various areas. And a pleasure to always come to a class which is graduating for better things to do in life. I don't have a prepared speech, but I thought that since Indian Forest Service and the armed forces share a lot, let me speak to you about a lot of things which will probably come in handy to you. It will probably help you in how you conduct yourself in the subsequent life. And when I say there is a lot in common between armed forces and the Indian Foreign Services, it is because of the way we all lead our lives. And there are a lot of commonalities. We tend to stay away. We tend to have similar problems in finding accommodation. We have similar problems in finding schools for our children. We have similar problems when you have done a particular language, but you land up in somewhere where you don't know the language. We have similar problems. Let me start by saying that your good days are over. Till now, you were officer trainees, you could do mistakes, and now you are going to be officers who cannot do mistakes. And there is a great difference. I would like you all to not only feel that difference, but to understand that difference. Because from now on, you are in the spotlight. From now on, you are under scrutiny. From now on, people will be watching you. From now on, people will be judging you. Till now, it was only peers. Till now, it was only the faculty. But now, the world is going to enlarge for yourself. And you need to prepare yourself. Prepare yourself from what you have learned here. Prepare yourself from the varied experience you have. And prepare yourself from what you already have in you. And this will come in handy to you when you walk out as officers from this. What to expect as an officer? The first thing that you should expect is that in your initial days, there are a lot of people who are going to make an impression about you. And my experience says that generally those impressions last for a lifetime. So when you say put your best foot forward, you need to actually do so. People will judge you. And there are varied ways. It is not just the peers, it is the people who work under you. They make a judgment. The way you walk, the way you dress, the way you talk, the way you handle things, the way they see in you how much of empathy you have, the way they see how much of firmness you have. Both have to go together. It cannot be just one part. It is your entire character that is judged. And again, I'm talking from experience. Juniors do not take too much of time to judge you. The judgment is very fast. They'll decide whether they can take liberty with you by knowing that you will not care for that work, or they know that they cannot take liberty with you because you are firm. You will not allow that to happen. So it is this period of the first foundation that you lay for yourself that will decide how people will subsequently judge you. And that's why it's very, very important that what you have learned, you keep recalling it time and again. Go back to what you feel is right and go back to what you feel should take you forward. And let me just pepper it with a little anecdote from the army days. And it's just a sample of how things happen. It is different in the army, but a similar thing can happen with you. When I joined the service, my unit was in Delhi. In those days, there used to be only one unit in Delhi, half in Rashtrapati Bhavan, half preparing to do all ceremonial duties from the Red Fort. And the second day in the unit, my boss, the commanding officer, told me that just like Tirke and others who are good in sports, you take the sports team out. Now the sports team was well prepared. They decided there is a new man who has come, we will test him out. So we started going, and as I had been taught, you know, you must always lead, officer always leads. So I stood with them and we started running, and I was in the forefront, and they took me for a real ride. They had the long distance runners. We started from the Red Fort, came to Shantivan, from there we went to the Old Bridge, and then we came to the Nizamuddin Bridge, and we crossed over. I barely managed to keep up with them. And when we reached Shantivan back again, I found, except for these two and me, rest everybody was lying on his back and looking at the sky, enjoying himself. Well, we got them together, we came back, and I realized that I had been had. They've taken me for a ride. And on top of it, when they rubbed it in, when I broke them up, they said, today afternoon, when you have a nap, use a quilt so that your feet don't hurt tomorrow. Well, I digested it, and I decided that I must get my bag on. And next day, we again started on the same routine, and I said, I want to be right behind so that everybody stays in front of me. And I took them on the same route. I was tired. I wanted to give up. But I said, I have to tell them that I am the officer and not they who can take me for a ride. So we came back and I did the same, and I told them, this afternoon when you people relax, put a blanket on your feet so that you don't have trouble tomorrow. Well, that ice was broken between us. They realized they could trust me, and I realized I could trust them. That is important in the armed forces, but so is it important in the foreign service, because if you do not have trust in the people who are below you and they do not have trust in you, then things will go wrong. And you have tremendous amount of responsibility that comes to you. Foreign policy may be shaped here, foreign policy may be tweaked here, but you are the implementers. You are the people who will be on ground doing things so that the nuts and bolts of that foreign policy are fine-tuned to an extent where it achieves what it is meant. And let me tell you, the world of diplomacy is very interesting, because you are not only being washed by your own people, you are being washed by all the other missions, you are being washed by the country in which you serve, and they are all looking at you. And they also make an impression of you. They know whether they can get by, they know whether they can fool you, they know whether they can pull a fast one on you, and it doesn't take much time to judge each other. And that is what is important for you to know, that the whole world is going to look at you, and therefore your conduct has to be impeccable, absolutely impeccable. You've got to have character qualities, you've got to have integrity, you've got to have firmness, you've got to have politeness, you need to be diplomatic, and yet know what your country wants from you. It's a mixture. It's a mixture which can bring down a lot of people. And let me also assure you, in all this, you also have allurements. You have obstacles which will make you fall. There'll be people who will look for signs of weakness in you. There'll be people who will see as to how they can manipulate you. Because there are too many agencies and forces working. And therefore, when you step out as officers, keep this in your mind, that you are the representatives of this country. On you depends how the foreign policy objectives will be fulfilled. On you depends how things will be moved forward. You are the ones who will read between lines. You will read the fine print before either a trade agreement is signed or before any other thing is made. Because if that is not done properly, then somebody else will come to grief. So you have to be meticulous to the extreme. You have to be industrious, you have to persevere, and you have to be determined. Now, I've told you so many qualities that you must be thinking it is going to be a difficult life. Yes, you've chosen a difficult life, you've chosen a difficult career, and that is the beauty of it. So, prepare yourself. It will be something which will be unique. And language is one thing which will take you forward. And like I said earlier, all governments and organizations are expert at sending an expert in something somewhere else, so that he runs something else. So you may have learned Spanish, but you might land up in France. You have to relearn everything. Prepare yourself. Be flexible. Have your mental abilities so flexible that you should be able to pick up another language in a short time frame so that you can get by. It is important. When you talk to somebody, wish somebody, shake hands with somebody, and you're able to speak in that language, the ice is broken. It makes a difference. And it also conveys to them that they cannot talk in their language and say something which you won't understand. So all that I would say is, being an officer is tough. And being an IFS officer is even tougher. And that is why a lot of grilling has taken place in these 2 years that you've spent here. And I feel that there is a great amount that can be done by you to ensure that things go right. Always remember, when you give a report, you must know what you are saying. And it is not words. We always say in the armed forces, one visit to ground is better than 1,000 reports. What comes from you is what will be acted upon. So if you have gone wrong, you can imagine what will go wrong subsequently. And remember, be truthful to yourself and truthful to the country. That is what is the trust that people will have on you. In the end, I wish you and your families the very best. I'm quite sure we will have the best of results from you. We will know that where you are, we can expect things to go right. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir. I'd request the Honorable Minister of State to kindly remain on stage for a group photograph with the officer trainees. May I have time for a photograph to join us on the stage?
सभा में उपस्थित समस्त सम्मानित अतिथिगण और मेरे प्रिय साथियों, आप सभी को मेरा सादर नमस्कार। आज महोदय के हाथों से ये सम्मान प्राप्त कर मैं स्वयं को कितना सौभाग्यशाली और गौरवान्वित महसूस कर रही हूँ, ये बताने का सामर्थ्य मेरे शब्दों में नहीं, क्योंकि शब्दों की भी अपनी एक सीमा होती है। फिर भी आज आप सभी के सामने मैं अपने मन की बात कहना चाहती हूँ। मैं सहृदय आभारी हूँ ईश्वर की, अपने गुरुजनों की, विदेश सेवा संस्थान की, अपने परिवार और मित्रों की, जिनके निरंतर मार्गदर्शन और सहयोग से आज मुझे ये सौभाग्य प्राप्त हुआ। महोदय, मेरी दृष्टि में ये मेडल मात्र एक सम्मान चिन्ह नहीं है, अपितु ये प्रतीक है उस दायित्व का, उस कर्तव्य का, जिसके निर्वाहन के लिए मैं और मेरे सभी साथी प्रतिबद्ध हैं। अपने कार्य क्षेत्र में प्रगति करते हुए राष्ट्र के उत्कर्ष में सहयोग देना और देश विदेश में बसे भारतीयों की अपेक्षा पर खरे उतरना, ये दायित्व बिल्कुल आसान नहीं है। मेरे विचार से इच्छा शक्ति, विद्या शक्ति और क्रिया शक्ति के बिना ये लक्ष्य संधान संभव नहीं। महोदय, आज मैं और मेरे सभी साथी मनसा वाचा कर्मणा पूर्ण सत्यनिष्ठा से अपने आप को भारतीय विदेश सेवा के प्रति समर्पित करते हैं। मैं अपने वक्तव्य का समापन श्री हरिवंश राय बच्चन की एक कविता की कुछ पंक्तियों से करना चाहूंगी। स्थल गया है भर पथों से, नाम कितनों के गिनाऊं, स्थान बाकी है कहां पथ, एक अपना भी बनाऊं। विश्व तो चलता रहा है, थाम रहा बनी बनाई, किंतु इन पर किस तरह मैं कवि करण अपने बढ़ाऊं। राह जल पर भी बनी है, रूढ़ी पर ना हुई कभी वह, एक तिनका भी बना सकता यहाँ पर मार्ग नूतन। तीर पर कैसे रुकूं मैं आज लहरों में निमंत्रण, तीर पर कैसे रुकूं मैं आज लहरों में निमंत्रण। धन्यवाद। जय हिंद।
I now request Ms. Veena Prabha Tirke, Officer Trainee of 2014 Batch, to kindly propose a vote of thanks.
Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs, Ambassador Amitabha Tripathi, Dean FSI, respected dignitaries, guests, my dear colleagues from IFS 2014 Batch, ladies and gentlemen, I feel honored and privileged to get an opportunity to propose a vote of thanks on behalf of my badge on this auspicious occasion of our valedictory function. At the outset, I place on record my sincere gratitude to Honorable Minister of State for External Affairs, General Dr. Vijay Kumar Singh, for gracing today's occasion with his kind presence and sharing with us his vision for Indian diplomacy, foreign service, and showing us the responsibilities and challenges lying ahead for us and expectations from us. We are grateful to you, sir. We assure you to continue to work in the direction of taking our country higher on the world stage. I thank Ambassador Amitabha Tripathi, President Association of Indian Diplomats, for his gracious presence in this ceremony. We are greatly encouraged and immensely benefited by your inspiring address. Profound thanks and gratitude are due to Dr. Amrendra Khatwa, Dean FSI, for his unstinted support, encouragement, and guidance rendered on us. I wish to take this opportunity to extend my gratitude to our former Dean FSI, Ms. Nengcha Luvum, who had been the driving force behind this whole process of our training program in FSI. I wish to thank her for the effort she had put into developing the training agenda for us for our overall development. It's a matter of immense pride for me to convey my gratitude to our JSFSI, Ms. Sangeeta Bahadur, for adding new dimensions in our training schedule in a most befitting manner, though we spent a very little time with her in FSI training. Now I register my profuse thanks to Sri G.V. Srinivas, our former JSFSI, under whose guidance we spent most of our training period. Was instrumental in arranging our training lectures, webinars, assignments, as well as providing a stimulating environment throughout our training period. It is his vision and leadership that made our training interesting. Sir, you have guided us in the right direction, and we appreciate that. Special thanks and heartfelt gratitude are due to our course coordinator, Mr. Amarnath Dubey, and our former course coordinator, Mr. Mayank Chaubey, for planning and executing our entire training program. Teamwork divides the task and multiplies the success. On behalf of the entire batch of 2014 IFS, I shower my heartfelt thanks and gratitude to all the staff members of FSI family, technical staff, mess workers, physical trainers, sports coaches for extending time and their wholehearted support on us, both in the foreground and in the background. It will be evergreen in our memory. Thank you all for your invaluable contribution. I convey thanks to all the distinguished assemblage of the guests in this auditorium for their august presence amongst us on this auspicious occasion, who have come from distant places to attend the function and to share and enhance our happiness. Finally, last but not the least, I thank all my young and energetic batchmates of 2014 batch for being amazing batchmates and who will be friends for a lifetime. Indeed, it was an enriching and edifying experience being with you all. Before concluding, I once again acknowledge the contributions of all those whom I might have forgotten to mention right now, but who have made our training successful and memorable from the first day to this valediction day. I thank one and all. Dear friends, there are great times ahead of us. Country needs our service. Wishing you all a bright and shining career ahead. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we conclude this valedictory function, I'd like to take this opportunity to invite everyone for tea and snacks. Thank you.
You know, space denial. How do you deny space? You know, yeah.